Again, in this illustration, we'll see the similar structure of a cubical frame of capacitors, where we are given that figure shows a wire frame with 12 capacitors. Here again, we assume each capacitor is of capacitance C, and we are required to find equivalent capacitance across these terminals A and B. And in solution for nodal analysis, again, we connect a battery of 100 volt here. And in this situation, if we distribute the potential at terminal B, if we take it 0 here at A, we can take it 100. If we distribute the potentials by symmetry, we can see if here at point C, potential is X, at F, which is symmetrical with respect to B, potential will remain same as X. Now, by input and output symmetry on the two sides, it is 100 minus X at node E and same as 100 minus X at node D. Now, for this node G, we can take potential to be Y, and at H, it will be 100 minus Y. Now, we need to calculate two variables, X and Y, to find the value of X so that we can calculate the total charge which is flowing through battery, which is delta QF. Here, let us first write the value of delta QF which flows through the battery, that is through these three capacitor plates. So, charge on this will be Cx plus charge on this is also Cx plus charge on this is C multiplied by 100. So, charge flown through battery C multiplied by 2x plus 100. So, if we get the value of x, we can calculate delta QF, and equivalent capacitance can be obtained by delta QF by 100. So, here first we write equation for x. For node X, we can write the equation as Cx plus, for this it is C multiplied by X minus 100 plus X plus, for this capacitor it is C multiplied by X minus Y is equals to 0. On simplifying here, C gets cancelled out and we are getting 4X minus Y is equals to 100. Say this is our equation 1. And now if we write equation for Y, again there are three plates connected to Y, so equation we can write C multiplied by Y minus X plus, for this again C multiplied by Y minus X plus, for this it is C multiplied by Y minus 100 plus Y is equals to 0. C gets cancelled out and on simplifying we are getting 4y minus 2x is equals to 100. So this is our equation 2. So 1 and 2 are two linear equations and two variables. So we can directly solve these equations as 1 multiplied by 4 plus 2. So if you multiply it with 4 and add in 2, this y gets cancelled out and this will result as and this 16 minus 2, 14x is equals to 500. So, the value of x we are getting is 250 by 7 volt. So, this value of x we can put it over here. So, this will give us the value of delta Q and C across terminals A and B. We can write delta QF by 100. So, the C multiplied by this 2x means this will be 500 by 7. Plus 100 divided by 100. Here this 100 gets cancelled out and the result I am getting for CAB is 12C by 7. That is the answer to this problem. Here you have seen that we have calculated the equivalent capacitance across terminals A and B by using the method of nodal analysis. The same you can also solve by using the alternative method we have seen in the previous sections, where you can join equipotential points and you can solve it by series and parallel capacitances. So here I am leaving it as an exercise for you to get the same result by using that alternative method. So please solve it and keep it for your record.